I would like to share a message with you taken from the book of Isaiah chapter 46.
让我们先来看一个广告。
Let us look at an advertisement.
Okay, 谢谢。所以我在这里呢，不是要为 Dynamo 打广告啊。
I'm not selling advertisement for Dynamo.
只是要用这个广告来做一个例子。
We'd like to use this advertisement as an example.
所以你们看了刚才那个广告，右边的那个洗衣液能够清除污垢，然后晒在屋内又有这个芳香的气息，你们会选择左边还是右边的洗衣粉呢？
From the advertisement, the laundry detergent on the right, can remove the dirt and is fragrant even when the clothes are hung in the house. Which laundry detergent would you choose?
所以我相信大多数都会选择右边的洗衣液。
I'm sure you choose the one on the right.
所以呢，在圣经里面，我们的上帝他也有把自己跟其他的神明来做出比较。
Our God also compare himself to the other gods.
目的就是要让人知道他是真神。
His main purpose is to let us know he is the real God.
在还没有看以赛亚书四十六章之前，我们来看一些的历史背景。
Let us look at the example from the past.
Okay, 在所罗门王他年老的时候
，When King Solomon at his old age，
他的心就偏离了上帝，他就跑去跟随他的废兵去敬拜别的神明。
His heart deviated from God.And he followed his concubines to worship idols.
然后因为这一件事情，上帝呢就对所罗门王来发怒。
And because of this, God became angry with Solomon.
然后他就把他的国家赐给一个臣子。
And he gave his kingdom to a courtier.
只剩下一个支派，那就是犹大给这个所罗门的后代。
Leaving only one tribe to Solomon's descendants.
所以这样国家就分为。南国犹大还有北国以色列两个部分。
And in this way, the country was divided into two, the north and the south.
南北两国呢都常常背逆上帝，所以上帝就差派不同的先知去呼吁他们回转。
The north and the south often rebel against God, and so God had sent many prophets to deliver his messages.
然后其中一个很出名的就是以赛亚先知。
One of the famous prophets are Isaiah.
他主要就是向南国犹大来发出预言，发出信息。
He is mainly prophesies to Judah.
可是呢，犹大的人民常常听到这些信息，他们还是拒绝上帝，他们拒绝悔改，他们藐视上帝。
But the people of Judah had often heard the prophets' warning and appeals, but ignore the words.
所以呢，上帝就预言说，他一定会兴起巴比伦这个强大的国家来攻击犹大。
So God had prophesied that he would strike Judah with the hands of Babylon.
作为审判他自己的子民。
As a judgment.
不过上帝是慈爱，也是信实的，他也预言说。在七十年之后，他会兴起他自己的仆人来拯救犹大。
However, God is loving and faithful. He still cares for his chosen people. 70 years later, he will raise someone to rescue Judah.
所以上帝应许说，他的医治和复兴一定会降临。
God promised that his rescue and heal will revive Judah.
所以上帝就透过以赛亚在这一本书四十六章里面跟巴比伦的神明做出比较。
And through Isaiah, God compared himself to the gods of Babylon in chapter 46.
目的就是让人知道他有能力胜过巴比伦的神明。
The purpose is to let everyone know that he is God and he is.Ability to win over the gods of Babylon.
他有能力审判巴比伦，他也有能力拯救自己的百姓。
He got the ability to
judge.
to win against Babylon, gods of Babylon, and he also can judge, can save Judah.
Okay, 让我们一起来看以赛亚书四十六章一到二节。
Let us read together the book of Isaiah, chapter 46, verse 1 and 2.
我们一起念啊。比勒叩拜尼波屈身，巴比伦的偶像躲在走兽和牲畜背上，你们所抬的成了重驼，使牲畜疲乏。这些神明一同屈身叩拜，不能救自己，反倒招人离去。所以当时候，每一个国家都有自己所敬拜的神明。
At that time, every country had its own gods.
看啊。比如说迦南地，他们所敬拜的就是巴利跟亚瑟拉。
The Canaanites believe in Baal and Asherah.
然后摩亚人他们敬拜的神明叫做基莫。
The Moabites believe in Chemosh.
然后腓力士人他们是敬拜大衮。
The Philistines believe in Dagon.
然后亚门就是敬拜摩洛。
The Ammonites believe in Moloch.
而这个以赛亚书四十六章里面的主角巴比伦，他们所敬拜的就是比勒和尼波。
And the Babylonians believe in Baal and Nebo.
比勒是巴比伦国里面主要的神明。
Baal was the major god in Babylon.
他还有他的名字叫做 Marduk， 还有 Merodach。
He was also called Marduk or Merodach.
他呢就是巴比伦国所相信的天地之主。
He was known as the Lord of the heaven and earth.
然后国家的命运都操控在他的手当中。
And the fate of the nation was in his hands.
然后尼波呢，就是他的儿子。
Nebo was the son of Marduk.
然后呢，他是智慧、学习、预言还有写作的这个神明。
He was the god of wisdom, learning, prophecy, writing, and also the god of vegetation.
Okay, 然后他也是掌管植物的神。
He's the god of vegetation.
所以每一年巴比伦人他们都会庆祝一个节日，叫做亚基图节。
Every year the Babylonians would celebrate the festival of Akitu.
然后呢，他们就会带着尼波、比勒，还有一些的神明在马路上游行。
They would march on road with Baal, and Nebo and all other idols.
所以对他们来讲，比勒跟尼波是国家的守护神，是最有能力的神明。
To them, Baal and Nebo were the patrons of their country and the most powerful ones.
可是耶和华上帝却说，这些巴比伦人把这些的神像放在牲畜的身上，放在人的身上，反而成为了人和牲畜的重担，使他们疲乏困倦。
However, the Lord God Jehovah said that these Babylonians placed idols on the beast, and they became the burden of the people and the beast, making them tired.
此外呢，当巴比伦面对到灾难的时候，这些神明不单止没有办法保护他们的国家，连他们自己这个神像也被敌人掳到去外地。
Moreover, when Babylon faced disaster,these idols not only failed to protect the country, they also been taken into captivity by the enemy.
接下来我们看四十六章的三到四节。
Let's move to chapter 46, verse 3 and 4.
我们一起来念。
Let's read.
雅各家、以色列家所有的渔民啊，你们自从生下就蒙我抱，自出母胎便由我来背，你们都要听从我，直到你们年老，我不改变；直到你们发白，我仍扶持。我已造你，就必背你；我必抱你，也必拯救。所以，上帝在这一段经文里面发出呼声，他叫犹大人民来听他说话，因为上帝要对他们说慈爱的话。
God called out to Judah to listen carefully to the words of love.
犹大自从出母胎之后，是上帝在背负他们，在怀抱他们。
God has embraced and carried Judah from the womb.
一直到犹大头发已经变白又老了，上帝依然不会改变。
Even to Judah's old age and gray hair, God will still embrace and support them and will never change.
所以这段话呢，就是在提醒着犹大， 当初上帝是怎么样的把他们从埃及拯救出来。
This passage also reminded Judah how God had rescued them from slavery in Egypt.
然后上帝引导他们走过四十年的旷野之路。
And God also guided them through 40 years in the wilderness.
然后上帝呢给他们住在迦南地，是个美好的土地。
And God even gave them a beautiful land, which is Canaan.
然后上帝赐福他们成为一个强盛的国家。
And God also blessed Israel to be a powerful country.
这个是他们的过去。
That's the past.
不过呢，上帝也应许说，在将来的日子，他仍然会怀抱还有背负他自己的百姓。
God promised them, even in the days to come, God will embrace them and rescue them.
所以这一段经文跟刚才我们所念的一到二节是一个很大的对比。
This passage is a very great contrast to the previous one.
因为巴比伦的神明是人和动物的重担，可是耶和华上帝却是背负人重担的神。
Because Babylon's God were a burden to the people and the beasts, where God will protect them.
巴比伦的神明使他们的人和动物感觉到疲乏，但是耶和华上帝却赐给人有精神。
Babylon's God were a burden to the people and the beasts, but our God will bring peace to the people.
Okay, 接下来我们看四十六章五节。
Let us read chapter 46, verse 5.
你们将谁与我相比，与我相等，将谁与我相交，使我们相似呢？所以这是上帝在发出的一个问题。
In this verse, God posed a question.
他说：“你们要把谁来跟我这位上帝来相比
？”God asked, "Who can compare to God Himself?"
然后接下来我们念四十六章的六到七节。
Let us continue, verse 6 and 7.
我们一起念。他们从钱囊中倒出金子，用天平称出银子，故银匠造成神像。他们又俯伏又叩拜，他们抬起神像，钢在肩上，安置在定处，使他站立，不离本位。人呼求他，他却不回答，也无法救人脱离灾难。所以从这两节经文，我们看到人们呢是雇用银匠，把他们手中有的金和银打造成为神像。
In these two verses, the people hired silversmith to make idols out of the gold and silver, and then they bowed and worshipped the idols.
他们当他们这样子向这一些手制造出来的神像又俯伏又叩拜的时候，证明说他们所敬拜的其实是人手所造出来的。
When they bowed and worshipped these idols, which are handmade, that means that they are.
他们是在信奉所人手造出来的神明。
They believe in the gods that created by human.
然后他们所使用的材料是会朽坏的金和银。
And the materials used are.Only God, gold and silver.
所以当金跟银朽坏的时候，他们的神明也就没有了。
Once the gold and silver decayed, their God are gone.
而且这也是上帝所不喜悦的，因为人用上帝所创造的金银来打造神像，可是他们却没有归荣耀给那一位创造金银的上帝。
This is what.Also, God hates the most because the people actually use the gold and silver created by God to create idols instead of worshipping and glorifying God who had created gold and silver.
所以那一些人不单只是敬拜这些神像，而且他们也是把这些神像抬起来，然后呢就把它放在自己所喜欢的地方，他就不离开本位了。
The idols are.Created and moved and placed in a fixed place, and they would not leave the place.
虽然是说人在敬拜那个神像，其实那个神像是不能够行动的。
Although people worship the idols, they are actually statues that cannot move.
而且呢，是人要把它放在哪里，它就得被放在哪里。
And people will place these idols wherever they want.
虽然有人向他来呼求，可是呢，他却不能够回答。
Although people call out to it for help, it can't answer because it can't speak.
我们来看诗篇一百一十五篇四到七节。
Let's look at Psalm chapter 115, verse 4 to 7.
这边说，他们的偶像是金的，是银的，是人手所造的，有口却不能言，有眼却不能看，有耳却不能听，有鼻却不能闻，有手却不能摸，有脚却不能走，有喉却不能说话。
But their idols are silver and gold made by human hands. They have mouths but cannot speak, eyes but cannot see, they have ears but cannot hear, noses but cannot smell, they have hands but cannot feel, feet but cannot walk, nor can they utter a sound with their throats.
所以上帝说，这些被造的神像不能够行动，不能够说话，也不能拯救人离开灾难。
God tells us that these idols, they have ears but cannot listen, they got a mouth but cannot speak, they can't help us in disasters.
上帝当时这么说，是因为他的审判即将要落在巴比伦的身上。
God said so because his judgment was about to fall on Babylon.
结果历史证明了，这个当巴比伦当上帝的审判临到巴比伦的身上的时候，这些神明的确是没有办法保护他的国家。
As a result, history proved that Babylon's God couldn't save their nations.
根据但以理书的第五章
，According to the book of Daniel, chapter 5,
当时候呢是统治国家的是巴比伦的摄政王伯沙沙。Okay, 当这个 prince, 伯沙沙王他举办宴席的时候
，at a banquet held by Belshazzar，
然后呢，他就用从耶和华圣殿里面拿出来的器皿来喝酒。
They drank using the gold and silverware of the holy temple。
然后呢，他们一边喝酒就一边赞美那一些用金银铜木铁所石头所做的神明。
When they are drinking, they praise those gods that were made of gold, silver, copper, iron, wood, and stone.
结果呢，后来就出现了一个手指头在墙壁上面写字。
As a result, a finger appeared to write on the wall.
原来是上帝宣布他对巴比伦的审判。
And it was God announcing his judgment to Babylon.
结果就在那一个晚上，波斯国这个马代人大流士呢，他就攻打进入巴比伦，整个巴比伦这个强盛的国家就这样子的落寞了。
And that night, Darius the Mede killed Belshazzar, and the nation of Babylon was defeated.
Okay, 所以这就是我们看到他的神明没有办法拯救这个这么强盛的巴比伦国。
And through this, we can see that Babylon's God cannot save them.
Okay, 接下来我们看八到十一节。
Let us look at verses 8 to 11.
你们当记得这事，立定心意，叛逆的人呐，要留心思想，要追念上古的事。因为我是神，并无别的，我是神，没有能与我相比的。我从起初就指明末后的事，从古时便言明未成的事，说我的筹算必立定，凡我所喜悦的，我必成就。我招致鸟从东方来，招那成就我筹算的人从远方来。我已说出，就必成就；我已谋定，也必做成。所以上帝吩咐犹大，你要坚定不移的去思想，还有记得在上古所发生的事情。
God commanded Judah to remember and think resolutely about the former things, those of long ago.
因为上古以前所发生的事情，都在高举着上帝，都在述说着唯有上帝是真神。
The former things were all manifesting and proclaiming that He is the only God.
所以呢，在这边，上帝自己宣告说什么？他说：“我是神，并无别的，我是神，没有能与我相比的。”这是从我们的上帝他的口里面亲自所宣告的。
And here God proclaimed that, "For I am God, there is no others. I am God, and there is none like me." It's a self-proclamation of the Lord to let the entire race of Judah know.
所以从这边我们可以看到，跟刚才所说的那一个人手所造出来的神明不同。
Unlike the gods made by human hands, the Lord is.
我们的上帝是会说话的神。
Our God can speak.
我们的上帝用他的话来创造天地。
Our God uses His words to create the world.
我们的上帝用他的话来喂养人的生命。
Our God uses His words to shepherd lives.
我们的上帝他说出他的心意和计划，他也会成就。
Our God proclaimed that from beginning.
我们的上帝会说出他的心意还有计划。
Our God speaks His will and His plans.
他会成就他所说的。
And He will surely fulfill.
就好像他对犹大人说，他一定会从波斯国呼召他的仆人来拯救他们。那就是居鲁士。
上帝
说他会从波斯来呼召他所高立的居鲁士。
God proclaimed that he will call a man called Cyrus.
对，这个居鲁士呢，他是来拯救巴比伦离开，拯救犹大离开巴比伦的。
This Cyrus was called to save Judah from the rule of Babylon.
所以后来历史证明了，这一个居鲁士，他的确把犹大人民拯救出来。
And history proved that this Cyrus actually saved Babylon, saved Judah from Babylon.
然后呢，也是居鲁士派犹大人民回去耶路撒冷建造圣殿。
And also, Cyrus.
Cyrus sent Judah,
Judah
go back to Jerusalem to build up their temple. Okay. 所以我们看到上帝他能说话。
And we see God speaks.
上帝也会实现他所说的话。
And God fulfilled his plan.
证明他是一位能行动、能说话、能成就大事的神。
And prove that he speaks, he acts, and he fulfills his words.
接下来我们看十二到十三节。
Let us look at chapter 46, verse 12 and 13.
我们一起念。
Let's read.
心中顽固远离公义的人要听从我，我使我的公义临近他已不远，我的救恩必不迟延，我要为以色列我的荣耀在锡安施行救恩。所以经文很清楚地在告诉我们，
The scriptures tell us very clearly，
上帝正在对那一些心里顽固远离公义的人在宣布好消息。
God is announcing good news to those who are stubborn in heart and distant from justice.
他要为了以色列，还有为了他自己的荣耀，让他的公义和拯救临到。
For Israel and for his glory, own glory, he will soon deliver justice and salvation.
所以透过以赛亚书四十六章，
through chapter 46.
上帝在宣布他对巴比伦的审判，他也是在宣布对犹大的拯救。
God declared the judgment of Babylon and also announced the salvation for Judah.
Okay, 让我们来看从以赛亚书四十六章，我们可以学习什么
？Let us look at chapter 46. What we can learn from here?
Okay, 我们看到我们的上帝是胜过一切人手所制造的神明。
We can see our God is greater than all idols.
这个橙色的是讲到巴比伦民的神明。
on the orange column, it describes the Babylon's idols.
然后右边蓝色的呢是讲到我们的耶和华上帝。
And on the right, blue column, we can that's describe about our God Jehovah.
所以上帝说，巴比伦的神明是人和动物的重担。不能保护国家，也不能保护自己。
God tells us that the gods of Babylon is the heavy burden to the people and cannot protect the nation.
也不能保护
自己。And can't protect himself.
然后我们的耶和华上帝是怀抱还有背负他子民的神。
On the other hand, God Jehovah carries and holds his people till old age.
然后他有能力保护他的选民，他也有能力能够攻打他的敌人。
And he's able to protect his chosen people and able to defeat the enemies.
然后在下面那一部分，我们就看到这个巴比伦的神明是用金银所打造出来的。
And we can see, God of idols of Babylon are made of silver and gold.
他会朽坏，他不能行动，不能说话，不能拯救。
These idols of silver and gold is going to decay, and it can't move, it can't answer, and it cannot save.
而我们的耶和华上帝是自由拥有的，他是自己存在，不是人去制造出来的。
And our God is self-existing. It will reign forever.
我们的上帝呢是永远长存，虽然这个世界会改变，但我们的上帝永远长存。
Our God will reign forever.
然后他能够成就大事，他能够说话，他有能力能够拯救。
And he's able to act and accomplish great work.
所以当我们看到这个比较的时候，你们会选择跟从哪一位神？
After this comparison, which would you choose to follow?
所以我们都会选择我们的上帝。
I'm sure we will choose our God.
因为在这里我们说到，我们的上帝是无与伦比的神，没有任何的神明能够跟他来相比。
From here we can see our God is incomparable, and he has the victories against all idols.
弟兄姐妹们
，brothers and sisters，
这个社会里面充满着不同。的宗教还有各样的神明。
The society is full of all kinds of religions and idols.
他们就是不断的要吸引人去朝拜他们。
They constantly attracting people to worship them.
我们成为了基督徒，是不是代表说我们有100%的免疫能力，不会去敬拜这一些的偶像呢
？We as Christians, do we have 100% of immunity?Not to fool by these idols.
对于那一些有形有体的神像，我们基督徒我们看见了，我们很清楚知道，我不能够去拜。
We know that we can't worship the physical idols.
但是在社会里面也存在着一些的神明是没有形体的。
But there are some gods in this society that are not physical.
他会跟你说我很有能力，但我不是神明，我也不是宗教，所以即使是你是基督徒没有关系，你也可以一起来参与的。
And they will self-proclaim that they are powerful and there's no need to fear and you can worship them.
所以如果基督徒不懂得去分辨的话，我们也可能会掉入这个圈套里面。
If Christians do not know how to distinguish themWe might be deceived.
其中一个呢，就是新纪元运动。
One of these is the New Age movement.
这个新纪元运动呢，是很个人主义，然后是抵挡上帝的一个运动。
This New Age movement is an extreme individualistic movement and resists God.
新纪元运动呢，是把不同宗教里面的信念。还有操练集合在一起。
The movement combines the beliefs and practices of all religions and advocate that they are God.
然后它主要的信念呢，就是说，万有就是神， 神就在万有当中，所以你就是神。
And it said, God is all, and everyone is God, including you.
所以他们认为人就是神。
And they said, God, man is actually God.
所以他们不相信人有罪，他们认为人只不过是暂时忘记了在你里面有神性，所以你必须要把你的神性操练出来，把它带出来，那么你就可以成为神了。
They don't believe that people are sinful, but believe that people have all forgotten the divinity within themselves. So they must awake their inner divinity.
所以他们就会用一些的方法来把里面的神性带出来。
And they'll use methods and beliefs, includes always to bring up the divinity.
Okay, 其中呢，就是包括有占星术，有打坐冥想，有念瑜伽，然后他们也会求这个心灵导师的帮助，还有用塔罗牌通灵，甚至是用水晶的力量等等。
The methods include ways such as astrology, meditation, yoga, spiritual mentors, tarot cards, physics, and the power to seek crystals to uplift oneself.
所以呢，是很矛盾的。
It's a very contradiction.
因为一方面他们是相信自己是神。
At one hand, they believe that they themselves are God.
但是另一方面，他们又需要靠这些东西来帮助他们自己。
And in another hand, they rely on these methods.
所以这也是一种的拜偶像。
This is also idol worshiping.
Okay. 根据去年2018年美国的一个调查 ，Pew Research Center 的调查。
According to research by Pew Research Center in 2018,
他对一般的美国人做了一个的一个的调查。
They had conducted a study on a group of Americans.
然后他就根据他们对宗教的委身分成七个小组。
And they divided Americans into seven groups based on the religious level.
然后他要看当中有多少个人有新纪元运动的思想这些的概念。
And they were to find out the percentage of the people which have the New Age movement's ideal.
Okay. 所以呢，有七个小组，我只是把那一个最浅层的基督徒小组的这个 result 给大家看。
This is one of the groups.
最浅层的。
Which is the most devoted Christian.
对了，所以在这一个最浅层的基督徒群体当中，有82%的基督徒每一个礼拜都有出席崇拜。
In this group, there are 82% who attend services every Sunday.
然后有84%的基督徒每一天都有祷告。
And 84% of them pray daily.
然后100%的参加小组。
And 100% of them participate in care groups.
然后有94%相信在圣经里面所启示的这一位神。
And 94% of them believe in God, heaven and earth.
In Bible.
In the Bible.
然后97%的人相信有天堂。
97% of them believe that there is a heaven.
然后有91%的人相信有地狱的存在。
And 91% of them believe that there is hell.
所以很惊讶的，在这个小组当中发现有32%的基督徒相信人可以感知到超自然的力量。
And surprisingly, 32% of them believe that people have psychic ability to perceive supernatural forces.
然后29%的基督徒相信，在这个物质里面有属灵的能力。
29% of them believe that physical matters have spiritual power.
然后19%的相信轮回。
19%of them believe in reincarnation.
然后16%的相信占星术。
And 16% of them believe in astrology.
所以从这个调查我们可以看到，新纪元的信念其实已经渗透了基督徒的 生命里面，他们的观念里面。
So a New Age movement can be seen to have infiltrated Christians' life.
所以这就是基督徒不小心的陷入了在这一个所谓没有形体的偶像敬拜当中。
This is how Christians they worship this kind of idols. Yeah.
所以就让这一个的调查也成为我们的警惕。
Let this survey become our
warning.
Yeah, warning to us.
所以新纪元运动里面的操练还有信念，都是在否定上帝的能力，否定上帝的存在。
The belief and practices in this New Age movement is actually defy God's existence and power.
因为他们寻求的是灵界的能力，他们在敬拜的是被造物。然后呢，这一些人他们是要自己做神，他们不要去敬拜上帝。
They actually seek the power of spiritual realm, and they worship the creation. And they want to become God themselves.
试问这一些灵界的东西、被造物还有人类本身，又怎么样能够跟上帝来相比呢？
How can the spiritual realm and the creation of human can compare with God?
所以唯有我们的上帝是独一的真神。
And God is the only God that we can believe.
然后在今年的五月份。
In this May,
我们在香港的乐坛能够有看到一个很让人心碎的新闻。
We see a heartwarming news, heartbroken news
在香港
in Hong Kong,
就是郑秀文跟这个许志安的婚姻出现了问题。
That's the marriage problem between Andy Hui and Sammy.
然后同时在五月份呢，我也看到一个很温馨的新闻。
And at the same time, in May this year, I saw a heartwarming news.
就是在美国有一位90岁的老伯伯。
In America, there's a 90-year-old man.
他呢就骑着电单车载他的太太去医院。
He sent his wife to hospital in his motorbike.
很难想象这一个老伯伯，他90岁了，他怎么样能够超速呢？可是他就是因为超速的问题，就接到来自警察的一个罚单。
Because of his slightly speeding, and he received a speeding ticket from the police.
然后他就必须要上法庭。
And he needs to face the judge.
所以法官呢就体恤这个老伯伯年纪老了，而且他又这么爱他的太太。
And the judge sympathized that this man was old and still loved his wife.
九十岁还骑电单车载太太去医院。
And at his 90 years old and still in his bike, he sent his wife to the hospital.
所以法官就判他缓刑，20年之后再回来法庭报告。
And he was sentenced to probation and was asked to return up 20 years later.
所以当时候在法庭里面的人也是好像你们这样哈哈大笑。
And the verdict brought laughter to everyone.
所以我们可以看到，虽然他们已经结婚67年了
，although they had been married for 67 years，
可是这个老伯伯还是持守婚姻的承诺，一直到。头发白了，老了，他还是很照顾他的太太。
The old man remained committed to his promise in the marriage and loved and protected his wife until his old age.
所以在人世间，夫妻能够彼此相守到最后，是一个非常难能可贵的事情。
It is never easy to have this kind of situation.
而更难能可贵的就是上帝，他也愿意这样的。守护还有照顾我们，直到我们年老。
And God also promises to carry us till our old age.
所以虽然犹大的人民他们很多次都离开上帝，但是呢，上帝对他们的爱、对他们的眷顾一直都没有改变。
Judah have many, many times left God, but God still care for them.
所以同样的，对于现在的基督徒，上帝也把这个应许赐给我们。
God also gave us the same promise.
弟兄姐妹们
，brothers and sisters，
我们每一个人的生活里面都有不同的重担还有困难。
We have our burden in our lives.
有时候生活真的是很不容易。
Life is never easy.
有时候这些重担呢，就是背到人的身心灵都很疲乏、很困倦。
Sometimes these burdens wear us down and make us weary.
可能是经济的压力。
Perhaps it's our financial pressure.
孩子的问题。
The problem of our children.
身体的疾病。
Physical illness.
工作上的危机。
Working crisis.
或者是面对到我们亲爱的人那个生死离别。
And even if we face our beloved one leaving us.
所以今天我们都听到了上帝的话，上帝说他愿意一生都背负还有怀抱我们。
Today we have heard his word, and God is willing to carry us and embrace us forever.
即使我们的头发白了，年纪老了，他还是一样的照顾我们。
Even when we are old age and our hair turn gray, he will always take care of us.
只是有时候我们人对上帝是缺乏了信心。
It's just sometimes we are lack of faith in God.
我们要自己来抓住，我们不敢去把我们的重担交托给上帝。
We always like to depend on ourselves, and
我们不敢把它交出来给上帝。
We are worried to leave this burden to God.
所以我们人就常常有忧虑，有惧怕。
That's why we always fight with worry and fight with fear.
让我们再一次的念以赛亚书四十六章四节。
Let us read again, Book of Isaiah chapter 46.
直到你们年老，我不改变；直到你们发白，我仍扶持。我已造你，就必备你；我必抱你，也必拯救。所以，让上帝的话语再一次的给我们肯定：我们是他所爱的孩子，然后他有能力，他也愿意背负我们的一生。
Let us be reminded again that we are children of God, and He will sustain us, and He will carry us.
上帝在以赛亚书的第八四十六章八节还有十二节，他称呼犹大人为叛逆的人，为远离公义的人。
In verse 8 and 12, God addressed Judah as people who are rebellious, stubborn, and distant from righteousness.
听起来这些的称呼都很刺耳。
It sounds very harsh.
所以如果有人把你称呼为你是个罪人，你是个叛逆的人，你是个远离公义的人，你会有什么样的反应呢？
If someone addressed you as a rebellious person, a sinner, a stubborn person, how would you feel?
有一些人听见了，他们的心里面就很反感，然后他们就把耳朵关起来。
When some people hear this, they despise this and close their ears.
他们不喜欢被称为罪人，不喜欢圣经里面所说的罪。怎么老说我是个罪人？我都没有杀人放火。
They don't like to be called sinners. Don't like the sin that is pointed out in the Bible. I didn't do anything bad. So why am I always said to be someone who rebelled against God?
所以呢，他们就很抗拒基督教。
That's why they are very resistant to Christianity.
然后也包括有一些的基督徒，他们只是一面就是一面倒的喜欢听安慰人心、神爱我们的信息，一面倒。但是呢，当圣经里面提到罪的时候，提到悔改的时候，他们却不喜欢听。
And even some Christians don't like to hear messages about sins and repentance, and instead they like to listen.To comforting words and words about God's love to us.
如果讲员他不够坚定，他看到基督徒不喜欢听的时候，他就好了，这样我就以后不要讲罪，我不要讲公义了，我只讲爱就好了，我只讲恩典就好了，那么就变成大家都在自己骗自己。
And if the speaker is not firm enough, once he sees the rejection from the some Christian, he might just preach messages that please the congregations and speak only of grace. Then
大家都在自己骗自己。
In the end, we are like deceiving ourselves.
的确，在圣经里面有讲到很多上帝的恩典，但同时也有讲到上帝所不喜欢的罪，他在呼吁我们悔改。
In many verse in Bible, it says about
grace.
Sins and rebellious, and he also talk about love.
Okay.
He asks us to repent.
在罗马书的十一章三十二节里面说，因为上帝把众人都圈在不顺服中，为的是要怜悯众人。
In Romans chapter 11 verse 32, for God has bound everyone over to disobedience, so that He may have mercy on them all.
所以上帝有时候把我们称为罪人，不是因为他要羞辱我们，而是因为他要让他的怜悯和救恩临到我们的身上。
Sometimes God addresses us as rebellious people and sinners, not to humiliate us, but to have mercy on us and save us.
对于这样的称呼，保罗他没有反对，反而他是谦卑的承认，在罪人当中他是个罪魁。
Paul did not subject to such titles, but humbly admitted that he was a sinner, and he was the worst sinner of them all.
提摩太前书的一章十五到十六节说，这话可信，值得完全接受。基督耶稣到世上来是要拯救罪人，而在罪人中我是个罪魁。然而我蒙了怜悯，好让基督耶稣在我罪魁身上显明他完全的忍耐，给后来信他得永生的人做榜样。
In 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 15 and 16, here is a trustworthy saying that deserves full acceptance. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the worst. But for that very reason, I was shown mercy, so that in me, the worst of sinners, Christ Jesus might display his immense patience as an example for those who would believe in him and receive eternal life.
所以保罗是一个有身份、有地位、有知识的人，可是他却愿意在耶稣的面前承认他是个罪魁，到最后他领受了耶稣的救恩。
Paul is a Pharisee with status, knowledge and honor. However, he was willingly humbled himself to admit that he was the worst of sinners, and in the end he received salvation.
所以上帝为悖逆的人、为远离公义的人所预备的，就是他的爱子耶稣基督。
What God has prepared for the rebellious and those who are distant from righteousness is the Holy Lamb of God. Jesus was crucified.
Okay. Yeah. 耶稣被钉十字架，三天之后复活，他就是我们的盼望，我们的拯救。
Jesus was crucified on the cross and resurrected on the third day. He is the perfect atonement.
所以只要我们愿意谦卑承认我们自己的过犯的时候，那么这一个救恩就是属于我们的。
As long as we humble ourselves, repent, believe in our hearts, and declare with our mouth that Jesus Christ is our Lord, we will receive this salvation.
Okay. 所以我们从整个以赛亚书四十六章里面，我们看到上帝把自己跟巴比伦的神明做出比较。
God has compared himself with gods of Babylon in Isaiah chapter 46. Point.
然后他就发出一个问题。
And he pointed out a question.
你们将谁与我相比，与我相等？你们将谁与我相交，使我们相似呢？
To whom will you liken me and make me equal and compare me that we may be alike?
结果上帝的话语还有人类的历史证明了一个事实，就是唯独上帝是真神。
In conclusion, the words of God and history have proven the fact that only Jehovah, our Lord, is God.
他有能力可以成就大事，他是世人唯一的拯救。
He has the capability of achieving great things, and he is the only salvation of mankind.
所以在这世界当中，没有任何的人，也没有任何的东西可以和他比较。
Hence, in this world, there's no compare to him.
所以上帝是我们全人类应当信靠、顺服还有相信的神。
Therefore, he is the God that all nations should worship and rely on.